Hey guys, Sean Nalawani here of seannal.com and bodytransformationtruth.com. And today I want to explain one of the latest protein powder scams that's going on. And it's happening with even some of the biggest companies out there. And it's the practice of amino acid spiking. So whey protein is one of the very few fitness supplements out there that gets a definite thumbs up from me. It's a very high quality source of natural protein with a top amino acid profile, high bioavailability, and that helps you hit your overall protein and calorie needs throughout the day in a far more convenient and streamlined way. It certainly isn't mandatory, but for most muscle building and fat loss trainees, it definitely can help out. But with whey protein costs constantly on the rise right now, and with literally thousands of different brands out there for you to select from, you need to choose carefully in order to ensure that you're truly getting a high quality product. So what is amino acid spiking? Well, as you probably already know, amino acids are the individual building blocks that make up a complete protein. There are 22 standard amino acids that are recognized, with 9 of those being considered essential since your body can't make them on its own. Amino acid spiking is essentially the practice of dumping high amounts of the cheapest, least valuable amino acids into the powder in order to cut costs while keeping the total protein content elevated. For labeling purposes, the total protein gram amount that's listed on the product is based on the total nitrogen content. And as a result, even though these isolated amino acids are technically not protein, they'll still contribute to the total. And this means that you're not getting a complete source of protein when using these products. And it also means that you're getting higher amounts of some of the least effective amino acids for supporting muscle protein synthesis and recovery. The specific amounts that are used are certainly going to vary from product to product. But to my knowledge, some companies are currently spiking as much as half of their total protein content with these low quality aminos. In other words, you might think that you're getting 30 grams of high quality protein per scoop, when in reality you're only getting maybe 15 grams along with a bunch of nearly worthless filler. Even for the companies that do this on a smaller scale with maybe just a few grams of these amino acids per scoop, in which case it probably isn't going to actually impact your bottom line result in a negative way, why would you purchase a spike protein powder when there are so many other legitimate options available to you? Why not get your full money's worth? And on top of this, why would you want to support a company that is being blatantly dishonest with you? So how do you know if your protein powder is spiked? Well, just go ahead and look at the ingredient list on the label of the product that you're using. The first thing you're going to see is the type of protein listed, whether it be whey concentrate, whey isolate, a blend of the two, or a mix of other protein sources like egg or casein or milk protein. Then simply scan the rest of the ingredient list to look for singular amino acids that have been added in. For the purposes of amino acid spiking, the two most common amino acids you're going to see are L-glycine and L-taurine. These are two dirt cheap, non-essential amino acids that cost far less than the actual whey protein. Since they're also tasteless, adding them in high amounts helps to improve the overall flavoring of the product. Another thing that you can look out for is added creatine. Creatine is also far less expensive than whey protein is, and since it's a combination of three amino acids, L-glycine, L-arginine, and L-methionine, it also registers as part of the protein total. Creatine is a great muscle building supplement, and it's something that I personally use and do recommend, but the truth is that it has no place in a protein powder and should simply be purchased separately on its own. So if you see L-glycine, L-taurine, or creatine listed anywhere in the ingredients list of your protein powder, it should raise a massive red flag. And in my opinion, the specific product should be avoided. Although it's not a guarantee that these amino acids are contributing to the protein total, I'd say that the chances are near 100% that that's why they're there. And since supplement companies know that the vast majority of people out there really have no idea about this particular practice, they'll actually play it up by giving fancy names to the amino acids because it makes it look like they're being added in for a specific reason. For example, one very popular brand out there includes what they call an NOS complex in their ingredient list, which is basically just a mix of L-arginine and L-taurine. Another popular product lists a muscle recovery matrix, and this is made up of creatine and L-glycine. It's really nothing more than pure marketing BS. And finally, what are some good solid whey protein products out there that are not spiked? Well, there are certainly many, many brands out there for you to choose from, but three that I would personally stand behind and recommend are number one, Optimum Nutrition 100% Whey. This is the one that I personally use. Number two, Dimatize Elite Whey. And number three, Cellucor Core Performance Whey. Now, these products contain a clean blend of whey protein isolate and whey protein concentrate, with whey protein isolate being the more prevalent of the two. They have no singular amino acids added in, they mix well, they taste good, and they're also reasonably priced. And it should be noted that I'm not affiliated with these specific brands, and I don't stand to gain anything by recommending one specific protein brand over another, so I'm really just giving you my very best recommendation there. So thanks for watching this video lesson. I hope you found the information useful here today. If you did enjoy the video, as always, please make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. Also, make sure to check out my complete step-by-step muscle building and fat loss programs over at bodytransformationtruth.com. The link for that is in the description box below. And make sure to join the Facebook page for daily tips and updates. The link for that is also in the description box. Talk to you again soon.